there's a power outage, your food is spoiling in the fridge, the power's not coming back on for another 24 hours. What are you gonna do? People spend a lot of money on these fancy power stations, myself included. What if I told you you could build your own power station at its very simplest with just these components for less than half the price? This is gonna be the most basic of power station setups. You're gonna learn how to do it before I finish my coffee. I'm gonna start this video by saying, if you're big into solar power and you know everything there is, this video isn't for you. This is for people who are just wanting to get a sort of a basic understanding between the difference of a do-it-yourself 12 volt system and fancy pants here at EcoFlow. I'm also gonna say, if you've got the money and you're running out of time, just buy this, hands down. For this setup, I'm gonna be using the Renogy 1000 watt pure sine wave inverter, a fuse, there are different kinds of these. And then we've got a 12 volt lithium battery that EnjoyBot sent me for review. I gotta say, when this came in the mail, the guys at work were like, EnjoyBot, is that a man toy? And I told them that's exactly what it is. This is the EnjoyBot 12 volt, 150 amp hour LiFePO₄ lithium battery. Full disclosure, EnjoyBot sent me this battery for review. So this thing packs 1920 watt hours of usable energy. It has 150 amp smart BMS, built-in Bluetooth monitoring, and an automatic self-heating feature, meaning that I can safely charge this in cold weather without killing the cells. For Canada, that's a big deal. It has 50% more storage than my old 100 amp hour battery in the same size. It is time to put the safety glasses on and open this box up and actually see what is inside of this thing. Dude, this is not that kind of channel. You're gonna kill yourself. He's actually totally right. Let's keep this super simple. Inverter, fuse, battery. First thing you wanna do is insert a fuse between your positive terminals. There's lots of different types of fuses you can use. And this is one of them. Okay, now we got that done there. And now we just want to hook up our negative. Make sure the inverter is turned off. And folks, we now have a power station. Just to shed some light on the matter and to prove that this is a working power station, let's plug some stuff into it. Lights. Hey, Joe, you should mention about the sleep apnea machine. Test that too.
Good idea.
Can you grab that for me? Also, you're wearing my hat.
Oh, God.
All right, happy bud. We got the light on here. Light's working fine. Let's do a CPAP test. I'm not gonna ridicule myself by putting a CPAP mask on. Luke.
I am your father.
Okay, let's just not lose too many subscribers here. All right, that's all working. There's your basic power station. Let's now hook this up to the cabin and actually use it and have a real livable test for the next
24 hours.
I love technology. I love simplicity and I love redundancy. The inverter outside is running to this UPS. So let's plug this in here. Let's turn everything on, make sure it's working, and make sure we can enjoy the rest of the weekend here. It is honey harvesting season, so I got my gear out. But here's our little kitchen light. We've also got these LED twinkly lights around the kitchen window that are working fine. Let's see if our guitar amp is working. Oh, very nice. Let's check our tick light here. This is a bonus because this actually has nothing to do with the power station. But you may notice that I'm wearing this classy tick repellent shirt. It is treated with permethrin. And this is my tick checker. So just a little bonus there for you off-gridders who live in tick infested territory. All right, back to your regular scheduled program. Get some lights on. Oh, very nice. You stop that. Okay, Bob, What do you think for dinner? Oh, good idea. Salmon it is. If you're a regular viewer of the channel, you've heard me talk a lot about redundancy. What happens when something fails? What happens when you forget to pick up the damn butane and you go to cook a nice dinner? Well, there's a couple of options. I can always go to the wood stove, or I can, you know, I've got the barbecue outside. But I figure this is actually a great test for this portable power station that we just built. This is a 500 watt kettle pot, so my inverter will handle it perfectly. But this, here's the challenge, right? We're gonna cook up some nice salmon. Hopefully it's nice. We're gonna do some mushrooms. We're gonna cook some Uncle Ben's converted rice. This is a garlic butter flavored rice. And what else do we got? Oh, we got some corn. We're gonna try and do it all with the kettle pot. Kind of because we have to. I'm not like a super big fan on precise measurements, so let's call it that much. So while that's doing its thing, let's pop the app open and see how much power we're using here. Let's get some dinner music on. I'm thinking a little Jethro Tull Aqualung will do the trick. All right, we just dumped our salmon in there. Let's see how this works. Let's get salty. It's just me now. Hey there. Okay, while the salmon is cooking up here, I just want to take a moment to thank you for watching and for subscribing if you have. The last couple of videos have had so many comments and a lot of views, and obviously there's a lot of people who are interested in power stations, whether it's a do-it-yourself power station like we built here or something fancy like the EcoFlow power station. Lots of debate on either side, some passion involved as well. So if you have a system that is comparable to this, you've done this, you've had the experience, or you're thinking about doing it, or you're really saying, oh my God, that's not for me, you know, EcoFlow, that's the way to go. I'd really appreciate your feedback. Salmon's cooking. Let's get the butter back in the fridge. Let's put our feet up for a moment, just chill and relax, because that's what we're meant to do up here at the off-grid cabin. All right, let's have a look at the app and see how much power we're using here. We are at 90%. We've cooked rice, mushrooms, and salmon. I've had the record player on. I have every single light on in here. I've got the laptop powering, and I've got my phones charging up. Oh, get back in there. That's a big chunk of salmon. All right, let's enjoy this nice, beautiful meal.
Hey everybody, welcome to Camping with Steve.
Wrong way. You don't want to confuse the front and the rear.
Okay, looks like we got enough power to watch a movie tonight. Woo! It's one of my favorite things to do up here is just chill out, relax, and watch a good movie. I just got a cheap video projector. Does the trick. Probably paid $100 for it. A beautiful fall weekend. I come up here to the off-grid cabin for peace of mind, and having power available when I need it gives that peace of mind. There's two routes that you can go here. You got your do-it-yourself power station route, or you've got your fancy convenient buy an EcoFlow power station, insert your favorite brand name here. Two different scenarios that can work in the right situation. There's a lot of things that you're not getting in the simple basic system that we just built, but it will get the job done. If you've got the money in the pockets, get a power station. If you've got the time and you enjoy tinkering, build yourself your own system. If you've got the time and money, do both. It's a great way to learn about solar power and how everything fits together. But, and there's always a but, right? On the flip side, a power station like the EcoFlow Delta 2 Max, you are getting a high quality inverter. All of the components are top of the line. You don't have to worry about getting a solar charge controller, for instance. This is a an inexpensive one, but you're still gonna have to shell out the bucks and get yourself the solar charge controller and all the cabling and all that stuff. EcoFlow, you don't need to, just don't need to worry about that. But there's certainly some advantages to going do it yourself. That's where, for me, the EnjoyBot battery is going to come in. Thank you very much, EnjoyBot, for supplying the battery for testing. It is a solid battery. There's enough reviews and teardowns out there that show solid internal components. It's well built, good BMS, and from what I've seen, there's no cut corners here. Time will tell, nothing to say negative so far. Tune into the channel because I like doing real world testing. So this was just a short test, but you're now going to see the EnjoyBot battery being used continuously throughout my series of videos up here. Happy off-gridding.
Hey, don't forget to tell people to subscribe, eh?
Subscribe, support,
and use the hype button. You can hype videos.
There's a hype button as well.
I'll teach you how to do it later.
Use that, but he thinks he's so clever.